I'm sure that even tomorrow, as it was predicted, that the rain will be falling so hard. But my prayer will be, I don't care how full be the rain would be, but so long that it will go along with the rain of the Holy Spirit. That it will be a latter rain for all of us to be ready for the Lord. The latter rain is one of the topics that many people in the Seventh-day Adventist Church have been reverberating here and there. Because without the latter rain, friends, we will not be able to see how the work will be done. As we studied the previous nights, we mentioned here that the latter rain will prepare the people before the close of probation. Where the close of probation is a time when the mercy of God, the door of mercy, will be closed. That's why we have the rain to ripen our faith. The rain to strengthen us to be reflected by the much less charm of Christ. And we studied last night that the sealing is going on. And we studied last night that it has started in the house of God. It's not only the church as a whole, but individually and corporately we need to be ready for the sealing. And we have studied last night, if you remember, that sealing is not only Sabbath keeping. According to Ellen White, sealing is more than Sabbath keeping. It is settling into the truth. It is trying to hold on the truth that we believe about Jesus. His perfecting and pardoning grace. A message that will prepare us for translation. Tonight, I will be focused more on our study of the latter rain. And I would like us to be attentive on some of the points, because many circles in the Seventh-day Adventist Church, they misunderstood. They try to teach a wrong explanation about the latter rain. We fully believe that we have the early rain, which is the seeding and the planting and trying to see that the Word of God can just be the seed that fall into that good soil where it will absorb and with the nutrients of putting that plant in place, it will grow as healthy as can be. And we will see that plant to be robust, healthy, with flowers very soon, and soon it will have fruits, and very, very soon you see that it will be a plant that has survived with good fruits. When you were trying to search about the value of the truth in Jesus Christ, and you were attending some of the Bible study groups many years back, when you were searching for the right way of life or the way of salvation, that was the time when the early rain is trying to put some watering into how that plant could grow. That was the time when you were still very cautious. You're still not so oriented of how we live as Adventists. And it's a learning experience, and finally, you seem to realize that what you're doing is not how Adventist lifestyle would be. And if ever you have known it better and you have studied the Bible better, you might have said, how I wish I have understood the Bible so that I was not, you know, unconsciously or consciously fell into sin. That was the earlier, at the time when you were receiving and listening and trying to embrace the wonderful truths of salvation. Now as we go to the latter rain in our study tonight, it is a rain that will ripen, number one. It is a rain that will help us go that we will surely be ready for translation. We will be prepared for the soon coming of Jesus. And the latter rain, my friends, has started. It's raining. It's raining to all of us. And I just want to let you know that the rain of the latter rain, as Ellen White says, that it will not fall corporately to the whole church. The rain will be felt individually. So if we say that we here in Virginia Beach, Seventh-day Adventist Church, we here in the Tidewater, Seventh-day Adventist Church, we here in the Potomac Conference, we will all wait for the latter rain so that corporately all of us will be ready then. No, my friends. It is an individual way for each member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church to receive and absorb the rain in our lives. I would like to go farther as we study tonight, because as we go deeper into the study of the latter rain, we will know and understand that when it comes according to Ellen White, when it comes according to Joel chapter 2, it will be given into full measure. It will be given to full measure. Now, I like what Ellen White said in the wonderful book or volumes of her writings, the Seventh-day Adventist Bible Commentary, Volume 7, page 1984, it says that the latter rain is coming upon us all and we must not wait. When we say, oh, I'm just waiting for the latter rain, it's still okay to do this and that. It's still okay to at least have a taste of how it is if you are in the world. I know a person that I called one day and said, my friend, I know there are so many instances in your life that God is calling you to come back to church. And he said, Pastor Vic, you've been my pastor for so many years, but will you give me at least one more year until I'll be able to build my rice mill, establish my resources, and when the day will come, when I have completed all my project in life, I will be retired. That will be the time when I will come back. About a month, I received another phone call that this friend of mine is in the hospital, trying to see, fighting between life and death. And finally, I was told that he told his wife, never mention this to the church. Never mention this to the pastor. Because I'm not ready after all. I am a sinner. And I'm not ready to do this. So tell the doctor to save me as much as possible. Because I'm not ready to die. I'm afraid. With the pleadings and with the advance of medicine, no matter how they remedied to save his life, my friend passed away, cursing the Lord and cursing everyone. Friends, we should not wait for the latter rain to fall. The latter rain is now in full measure, and that we as individuals must come to Jesus to surrender our all to him, my friends.
Amen.
Now, I like what Ellen White said in Selected Messages, Volume 1, page 111. It says that the time has come when we must expect the Lord to do great things for us. Our efforts must not flag or weaken. We are to grow in grace in the knowledge of the Lord. Before the work is closed and the sealing for God's people is finished, we shall receive the outpouring of the Spirit of God. What I'm saying here, my friends, is we must receive before the sealing work is finished. To those of you who were here last night, when did the sealing start?
1849.
You're all listening. I'm very good. It was in 1849 when the sealing started. And the work of the Lateran will encourage us, strengthen us, that we will be ready then when the Lord will come. Now, I would like to mention here four steps. Yes, four steps that each translated person must take. Now, there is a difference of a person that was saved and a person that is being translated. A person that is being translated is, he is in the situation where at any time he is ready to be taken to heaven. Oh, he will be able to be ready. We just like many others to go to heaven. If you are saved, it means to say, if when I say I'm saved, I can classify that into three areas. I, as we studied during the opening night, I am saved from the guilt of the past. And that is, I am saved through what we call the justifying grace of Jesus. When I submit my life to Jesus, when I surrender my all to Him, I am saved from the guilt of sin. I am saved from my past. And we studied also that I am saved every day through the sanctifying grace of Jesus. That I am saved from the power of sin when I come to Him daily and give my life to Him. How many of you are doing that since we came here for the revival? I'm so happy to see these hands. We need to do it by God's grace, sister. But again, I will be saved. And many people just look into that, I will be saved. They don't know that they're already saved from the guilt of sin. They don't realize that it's not only when we will go to heaven that we will be saved. We need to be saved every day from the power of sin, that we will be able to stand from the wiles of the enemy to tempt us to do sin.